Oh God! Oh!
My God, the Japanese are kicking their ass. Grenade! Ooh, goddamn. Is that a howitzer? Oh! That's some bloody shit, man.
The whole company is gone, Hank. The major is dead. We're being overrun. We have to get off of this hill.
That's one of our 50 cal still firing, Cole. The 22nd are still fighting.
Oh! Hank! I've seen some shit.
Looks like you're one of the lucky ones.
Am I?
Say goodbye to your friend Hank, Jack.
Oh!
He was your friend too, Cole. Is this how you're going to leave him? Are you wounded?
Not a scratch, Kelso.
Yeah.
Well, get up and get out of that fucking hole! Find a stretcher while you're at it so we can get him out of here.
Who's the senior officer here?
I guess that's you, Cole.
You were up here all night?
Yes, sir.
And your command?
Gone, sir.
Sorry to hear that, son. God damn it, we have beaten these bastards back. It's the beginning of the end, and it was one here. You're a goddamn hero, son. What's your name?
Lieutenant Phelps.
I mean, I've seen some shit.
I'm recommending you for the Silver Star and promoting you to First Lieutenant.
Fast cars, guns, and dope. That's right, everybody. I'm talking about LA Noire. As always, I'm Just Bravo, and welcome back. You know what? Enough of the shenanigans. Let's get down and see what our good old friend Detective Phelps and his good old buddy Roy have to offer this time in this new case. And last we left off, what were we doing? The setup. Yeah. Poor woman. She got knocked out. But she's dead. But you know what? Thank God, because we're starting with the Naked City.
10 Murata Avenue.
What?
Homicide wants you over there. The coroner thinks the broad was whacked using the army morphine. Don't say anything, Roy. Just get over there.
I was just going to compliment you on your shirt, Chief, but all right.
I didn't want to arrest the kid.
All right, Roy, let's get out of here. You're ready to tell you, you're starting a good day with the cop.
What's that getup of yours, anyway? I should start introducing us as Detective Earl, and this is my science teacher, Mr. Phelps.
Your interest in my appearance is starting to get me worrying.
Ooh.
Like it or not, we're a dysfunctional couple now.
You getting a little worried about me?
Same way they would a fat broad with a 5 o'clock shadow.
Yeah, Roy. All right. As always, it's gonna take a while. So get in the car, Roy, because we got shit to talk about. Okay, I guess you took the short way around. All right, let's head over there. Murder scene. I guess what? 2:24 p.m. I guess that cop's out there to introduce us. What a good man. Is he smoking? Okay. You know who I am, right?
In the back.
I'm fucking Phelps. Thanks. You dick. Alright, have another smoke. Whatever. What do you say? To something in the back? Fuck, I should pay attention. Alright, let's head up here. Roy, you're falling behind, and I should look. I'm guessing it's that open door. Bukowski!
Bukowski, you made homicide.
That I did. Good to see you, Phelps.
You two want a hug? Or can we get on with it?
Relax, Rusty.
Good old buddies.
26 years old, fashion model. Found in the tub by the cleaning lady, Mrs. Reynoldson.
There's your suspect. Call it in. We're good.
Carruthers likes to make work for people. Overdose of sleeping pills. Falls asleep in the tub. Rest in peace. Case closed.
Hear, hear. Mal is 100% that it's murder.
Do you mind if I take a look around?
Sure.
Go ahead. Take this combination like you did at my other jobs. All right, Mrs. Reynolds, we'll get back to you real soon. Yep, she's dead.
Val, we've had a look around. Rusty thinks it's a waste of time. What's your theory?
Come on, Mal. Tell us why we were dragged down here.
If the victim was alive when she entered the tub, water would have entered her lungs. The water is violently churned in the windpipe as she drowns. The result is that a lot of foam is generated. This foam is found at the mouth and nostrils in almost all cases of real drowning. Notice anything about our Vic?
May I take a look?
It's pre-rendered. You're not going to tell me? You're going to make me do your job? Fine.
Take a closer look at her head and neck.
The neck is bruised pretty badly.
She must have been choked. Yep, that's a choke mark. Well, at least it covered her up this time. Now I have to put a restricted on the next video. What's this? Is that a bite mark?
Bruising on the forearms, and these look like bite marks.
Do you have a dog? Are you testing me, man? I ain't got time for this. All right, let's see. Let's look at these. Another bite mark, a ring.
Very unusual ring.
I could be wrong, but it looks like a black sapphire. The eyes are a classic sign of morphine, and the bruises tell their own story.
She got beat up and dope?
One held her down, and another held her arm and injected her.
Oh!
Put her in the bath to try to cover it as a drowning.
It spread a trail of barbiturates.
Take a look around outside on your way out and see if you can find the Surettes. It would make my theory.
The morphine would have been very quick. And there wouldn't have been much of a struggle.
Okay, so find two guys who recently bought Surettes and weren't junkies, and you might be onto something.
Shit, way to tell me everything, alright. Let's, I already looked at you. Sorry. What do we got here? We got a hairbrush. My god, looks like a woman who wanted to keep herself pretty. Okay, that's it for that. Look at Roy, already working over the cleaning lady. what's this? Ooh, what's this?
English smoking jacket. I don't know anyone under 45 who would wear one.
And she looked like a pretty young lady. Not that I know. Don't tell my wife. Alright, let's see. Pills. Looks like Lewis was around here. Wait. Move it!
Looks like barbiturates.
What the hell does that mean? Okay, put that down. Alright, we got a bunch of Tylenol. I forgot, is that Tylenol that looks like that? Further investigate. Holy shit, that's a lot of barbiturates.
What else is rattling around in this thing?
Well, you look at it, Phelps, something like that doesn't stay like- Look, they're not even moving. God, I mean, look, what the fuck? It's just fake. Take one capsule after every meal once daily.
Prescribing both drugs would make her life a roller coaster.
Oof. Stoneman. Looks like his life was about to get hard. It's like this case. Roy's like, what? All right, let's look around. Anything else before we haggle on the young lady? Wait. Wasn't she the?
This is all top end of town stuff.
Oh man.
Gives us somewhere to look.
Hello there. No, wait. I can further investigate it. Nothing. What was the point? I'll put that down. I'm guessing, out of the other ones, but wasn't she the woman that was, like, not happy that we were there at the cannery?
A modeling assignment.
God damn, look at those teeth. My phone is not off. Alright. That was weird. Deassign 658-658-2. I'm working Tuesdays. Come keep me company. As for Miss Randall, this lady was working double edge. But seriously, those teeth. All right, what's this? I want a nice dress.
Beautiful girl. Clothes certainly aren't from the Sears catalog.
Oh, she must have had a sugar daddy back then, huh? The 40s. What the fuck am I saying? Oh damn. Alright, that's enough creeping around on a poor dead woman. I'll get to you real quick. Let's go check the kitchen. The rolling pin. She did the young mistress with the rolling pin in the kitchen.
I don't think this is anything.
Right? There's a lot of white stuff on it. Could be drugs. A ladle, I think. Nope, put that. Alright, Miss Whoever the hell you are.
I'm Detective Phelps. I'm here to try and help Julia. Do you mind answering some questions?
Virginia Reynoldson, I'm just so shocked. I feel like there's something I should be doing, someone I should call.
You can tell me the truth first.
Who needs to be notified?
That's just it. I don't know. Miss Julie doesn't have any family in town.
Did you kill them? There you go. She's a murderer.
Affairs in order. Mr. Henderson, maybe?
Who the hell's Mr. Henderson?
I don't know.
If you give the details, oh, he's like, bye. Ma'am, they can try and get in contact.
All right, so what's up with the victim?
Was Miss Randall depressed about something? Upset?
No more than normal.
A cleaning lady like you, talks a lot, and then they snoop around, girl. I know you're lying. Because that's a lot of drugs we found.
Here, Mrs. Reynoldson. Julia was obviously disturbed about something.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Bitch. Sorry? Isn't there, like, the fucking litter of pills all over the place?
She was taking barbiturates. She couldn't sleep. You must have seen them in her room.
Like, everywhere.
I've seen the pillbox. The things she hid in there. I don't know how she supported herself. Always new clothes and jewelry.
She was trying to fill a void in her heart.
She lived like a movie star.
But she never had her father's love. A poor case of broad.
Does modeling really pay that well?
I doubt it. Oh, she must have been getting
Does
a lot of help from other people.
Friends, is it?
I'm not sure. I only come around twice a week.
Girl. Let's look around. Well, what do we got? Let's look at the notebook real quick before I call anything. We got morphine? No. Possible suit? That has nothing to do with it. 2-carat black sapphire? No. Well, we gotta look for those guys. Man. Wait, got all excited. He did mention that. I mean, she was a pretty young looking girl. What the hell is she doing with a 45-year-old? Or what did Nicole say? That only 45-year-olds wear this? Prescription modeling job. Fuck it. Let's go. I'm gonna call you a lie and I'm gonna use that.
Why are you lying to me, Mrs. Reynoldson? Julia had men stay here.
I will not speak ill of the dead. You can't prove that.
Easy. Don't need to smack the table now. Oh, I can prove it. Oh yeah, it is. It does say men's smoking jacket.
Who owns the smoking jacket?
Huh?
I wouldn't like to tell tales, you understand.
She's dead. Tell us the truth.
Mr. Henderson.
Who?
An older man, very distinguished looking. He seemed very much in love with
her. There we go, we got a sick old pervert. Case closed.
I'm sorry. I don't know. He said he lives in San Francisco.
Ray, book a plane. We're on our way.
What was it like working for Miss Randall?
Perfectly fine, officer.
That's all right, there, it already gave me the answer. I got nothing, I got no evidence, because there's no, like, assault or anything. I'm going to doubt you.
Mrs. Reynoldson, it seems like there's something you want to tell me.
She was very high strung. Lovely one moment and screaming at you the next.
Sounds like a model.
She wanted it all. She wanted it damn quick. Of course, being so beautiful, it seemed like she was going to get it.
She got something.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynoldson. You've been very helpful. One of the other detectives will take your statement and then you can go home.
We'll take the drugs. All right, so, that's right.
We'll take a look around outside and then follow up these leads. Can you get some guys to run down the jacket?
Are we taking orders from this guy now? What a dick. Come on, Phelps, what do
you mean? You think Carruthers has called it right? He rarely gets it wrong.
I don't know. I'm a Galloway. I've met enough girls in my time who can't handle their dope.
Oh, there it is. There it is, look
Mal
at that.
Pleased.
Well, that's hardly conclusive, given the number of those things we've come across recently.
But why would it just be so happy to be right there?
One way or another.
I think our work
good looking,
here.
What the fuck? Probably. I got an achievement? Alright, fuck it, whatever. Probably nothing. Phelps, you gotta respect recycling. Alright, so where are we going off to next? Oh, the car's over there, shit. Find and inspect all the narcotics in Julia's. Why is that an achievement? Anyways, can I run? Why can't I run? Oh, there we go. What the fuck? All right, Roy, let's get over here. Let's see where should we head to next. We should go to the Sane, or we can go to the. Let's go to the Dr. Stoneman. That doc's got a lot of ants for giving her all those drugs. Oh,
Relax, woman. I'll take your...
Bukowski, Galloway, quite the little reunion in there. Almost brought a tear to my eye.
Yeah, they were better partners than you.
How would you know? You got promoted so fast you barely had time to learn their names. Let me fill you in. Bukowski's a pushover. Galloway's a drunk.
Well, yeah, that's obvious.
Learn a thing or two from both of them.
Please. They couldn't work a vice case if their life depended on it.
Oh,
I don't see why they'd be any better or worse at it than me.
I notice you said <He's> better. Like... Hubris disguised as humility. Kind of your trademark, don't you think?
I mean,
why
an asshole, bro.
Twist everything? Galloway's got nothing to prove. He's been on homicide for years.
And he's welcome to it. You're a terrier, Phelps, and that's what I need. Not some old bulldog who can't get up a flight of stairs without coughing
off
his lunch.
Look at you tell Roy's quite the friendly face around the police station. God damn. Why do I get so, like, in character? Dr. Stallman's practice, 2:41 p.m. Roy, you're an asshole, but you know what? You're my partner and the game won't let me switch. Absolutely fireproof. In case your ship burns down, it's all legal. Alright, let's get in there. Ding dong. Alright, so we gotta look at maybe these. Here it is. Dr. Stoneman's. Nothing here. Fuck. Could it be the other one? There it is. Of course, he's all the way at the top floor.
Here, Stoneman, office 505.
Alright, let's just take the elevator then. Wow, we actually get access to an elevator now. Come on, Roy. I never know. No, five was all the way down there.
If we locked up every doctor in this town, Vice would be able to work half days.
Roy, just sick of you already. 505. Where's 505? I'm guessing around this very well illuminated corner. Yep. Stoneman.
Yes, sir, your name?
The law.
LAPD. We'd like to see Dr. Stoneman.
Dr. Stoneman is with a patient. Would you like to wait?
Fuck no.
No, we wouldn't. Tell him we want to see him now.
There's no need to be rude.
I wasn't being
Save
rude.
It, sister.
Dr. Stoneman, I have some gentlemen from the LAPD
Phelps
here to
Booker.
See you.
Send them in, please. I'll see this patient again after they've left.
Really? We didn't know. Wow. Who the hell is this guy?
Your investigation is much more important than my sciatica. I'm just in pain here. Leave me alone.
Oh, what a bunch of... Roy, I'll take care of Dr. Stoneman. You take care of this guy. A cop! Before we head in there, you know. Whatever, no. Wait, why am I clicking it? Alright, Dr. Stoneman, got a lot to answer for.
We are investigating the death of one of your patients, Julia Randall.
I'm very sorry to hear that.
Bullshit.
Do you mind if we ask you some questions about Ms. Randall?
Not if it doesn't compromise doctor-patient privilege, Detective.
Really? What's up with your relationship with Victor?
How well did you know Ms. Randall?
Barely at all. She'd only been a patient 6 months or so.
My phone keeps ringing. Well, I know you're lying. Because I had a Benes, what was it called? Yeah, the needle. There it is. Prescribed by you.
Julia Randall has been your patient for nearly a year. I'm sure you know that.
Do you doubt my veracity, Detective?
You look like a guy.
Do you have access to my patient records?
But I got access to a dead body and a well hidden Benazidrine prescription.
Your prescriptions contradict you, Doctor.
Miss Randall
Shit.
Is in the fashion business, as you probably know. She was jumped up on Benzedrine by day and knocked down by sleeping pills at night. I told her to slow up, but no. Life was too short for her.
Of course, and then you killed her.
Prescription for the Benzedrine.
It's not illegal, Detective. A lot of young women in her line of work use it for weight loss.
She was practically a stick when I found her.
You wrote Julia Randall a prescription for Benzedrine. How can you account for that?
Miss Randall was in the fashion business. She wanted to control her weight.
Yeah. I don't know. He's not. I know he's. Let's see. Okay, where do you use the medicine description? We already used the sleeping pills. House statement. Mr. Henderson, nothing to do with the guy. We don't know if that's connected to him. Alright, I got nothing. I'm gonna doubt you.
Benzedrine is addictive, as I'm sure you know, Doctor.
As I warned her.
I don't need a PhD to tell you what's up.
She said she needed it to control her appetite.
Sounds like you knew her pretty well.
Looks like I knew her. She was involved in. I mean, look at you with a man with that kind of clothing.
Now, Dr. Stoneman, we'll be in touch.
All right. But you know, before we leave, I'm gonna snoop around. What's this?
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that.
Of course, you could just read it, Phelps. That's cool. Your blue bottle.
Not everything.
Nope, deodorant. No, that's it? Really? Okay, fuck it, whatever. Let's get out of here. Damn, you already do operations in here, Doctor? You're a man who likes to do everything in his office. Alright, can we, sneak around? Let's see if we could take some of his paperwork. Nope! Alright, let's get the hell out of here, Roy. Jump out the window. Make it faster. There, you're done. You jackass. Alright, Roy, let's get out of here. Yep. You know what? Fuck it. I'll see you guys over there. We're gonna head over to our next destination. Now! Bam! Desane's dress store, 2:51 p.m. Oh, hello there. Yeah, that's right, Roy. He knew. Oh. But before the case, hello, madam. That's right, I am the man from the papers. Don't smoke in front of my face, that's so disrespectful. You there!
Well, hello. What can I help you with today?
Oh. Sorry, madam.
Your lips are moving.
What the- what? Before we do that, madam, we're just gonna take a look around. Of course you all got something to hide, ladies. Dress, shoes, be hidden behind a mirror, a
LAPD,
window-
man. What?
I hope I haven't done anything wrong.
Except look beautiful, oh.
We're making some inquiries about Julia Randall. Does she work here?
No, I had to let her go. Is she in some sort of trouble?
Oh, she's dead.
She was found dead this morning.
I didn't do it, I swear to God. She had no reaction.
How long had Julia worked as a model?
Well, she worked in New York before coming here. She was a very beautiful girl.
A little dumb, but you know. Okay, that's the truth.
Could you tell us why you let Miss Randall go?
Husbands sometimes come in here with their wives. When Julia Randall modeled, the husbands were often more interested in her than they were their wives' dresses.
Ooh.
The wives weren't happy, and neither was I.
She take care of man too, girl?
Did she have any close friends here?
Actually, yes. Heather Swanson.
Ooh.
Would you like to speak with her?
I'd like that very much.
Yes.
Please don't inform her about Miss Randall's death.
Very well, officer.
Yeah, that's a weird.
Heather? These gentlemen are from the LAPD.
I'm Detective Phelps. This is Detective Earl. I understand that you worked with Julia Randall.
Roy's got his target on something else.
Julia helped me get my job here. She's not in any kind of trouble, is she?
She's a hellraiser, isn't she? Lives a fast life.
Oh, no. Maybe Mrs. Stanley would call her that, but I wouldn't.
Really?
She's full of life. Wonderful.
She was full of a lot of shit, too.
That's a lovely engagement ring.
Do you like it? Henry gave it.
Ooh!
Very interested in engagement rings.
Even the music got high, like, hmm? Just don't worry, I'm not gonna run off with it. He grabs her. Bye! Alright, let's see.
That's some pearl, Miss Swanson. Would have cost Henry a fortune. He must really love you.
Oh, yes, of course. Alright, so what's up with the victim, huh? You probably killed her. 22?
Don't go away, detective.
Oh, why did I
do? I want to know what this is about.
Relax, relax. Accidentally pressed the wrong button.
I was introduced through my fiancé, Henry Arnett.
Oh, yeah, she's telling the truth. I got nothing on this pretty girl.
Henry is your beau.
Look at that pre-rendered hair.
Yes, he is. Henry has a fashion business. He and Julia have been friends for years.
Oh, yeah, I'm guessing so.
Are Miss Randall and Mr. Henderson engaged?
Who's he?
She's like, what? Okay, yeah, she's telling the truth.
A sapphire engagement ring. Someone must have given it to her.
She never mentioned a man named Henderson to me.
Oh, well, that's it, okay.
Could you ask your fiancé to visit Hollywood Police Station? It would be very helpful to our inquiry.
Now, wait a moment. I don't think I'll pass on that message until you tell me why you're asking.
You're gonna be impeding on police questions, huh?
Julia Randall was found dead this morning.
That's right, that's what you wanted to hear? Hmm? Now pass the message.
Oh, no. Oh, I can't believe it. She She was so full of life.
I love how the game is like rendering perfectly the ring. Oh, okay. Oh, that was weird. Let's use the good old box. Okay.
Phelps badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective? Jesus.
Messages for me, please.
Yes, Detective. The coroner's been asking to speak to you. I can connect the call if you like.
Do it.
Please. Thank you.
Carruthers.
Al?
Cole, can you get over here? I just finished the autopsy.
Damn, you work fast.
Sure thing, Mal. We'll be right over.
All right, let's head over there. Let's go to the Hollywood Receiving Hospital. All right, we'll see you guys there. All right, Hollywood Receiving Hospital. Oh, nice getup, Carruthers. I think that's Carruthers. Mal? Whatever. Hello, ma'am. You're doing quite beautiful today.
Detectives Phelps and Earl here to see the coroner.
Yes, Detective. He's waiting for you in the examination room.
Well, thank you. God damn, everybody's kind of beautiful in Hollywood.
The women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy.
Oh, snap, dropping some knowledge by the janitor. See, guys? If not a handsome man, a handy one.
Fuck you!
Cole,
whoa!
I have some information for you.
Whoa.
You're the only person enjoying this, Mal. Get on with it.
The bruising confirms two sets of hands, so we have two killers. Death was caused by heart failure due to an overdose of morphine.
Have you dragged us down here to gloat? We already heard your theory.
We agree that she was murdered.
Yes, of course.
I have something else to show you.
This body.
All right, Mal, what gives?
The dead guy's name is Jimmy LeBlanc, career burglar. He came in this morning. Someone stove his head in with a lump of 2x4.
Ooh,
so
damn.
What? Good riddance.
I found two Surettes in his jacket pocket.
Wow.
Hang on a minute, Roy.
God damn, Roy, what an asshole.
No sign of morphine use and no metabolized morphine in his blood. Scratch marks on his face.
Which could be from getting his head remodeled.
Time of death, Mal.
Maybe an hour or two after the Randall girl.
So you're saying Laughing Boy here could be one of our killers? That's a hell of a long shot.
Thanks, Mal. We'll check
better
out.
Than what you got, Roy.
Mal, something else.
Oh, damn, this day just keeps getting better and better. Oh shit! Poor son of a bitch. And this poor girl. Look at you. So, can we close our eyes, Randall? I mean, damn. What are we looking at?
Sorry, I don't play. I don't know if it's significant.
Honer Comet.
The only other things he was carrying were the harmonica and the morphine.
That's weird. Hello?
Carruthers.
Oh, it is Carruthers.
Yeah, he's here. I'll send him over.
What up?
They have a guy called Henry Arnett in interview 2 for you next door. Let me know how you get on.
Sure, Mal. And thanks for the lead.
So sure, we got... Mal,
thanks for the lead.
Roy, I swear to God, man. God, what an asshole. All right. Well, let's head over there. That was a quick, nice little intro.
You can drive.
Do we know where we're going?
Wait. Oh, wait, why am I leaving? It's like right across the street. But was that everything at the hospital? Really? Let's see, I mean, it's still like open. Let's see what's in there.
This town is going straight to hell.
So it's you, man. You're the asshole. Why did you tell me to shut up, you dick? Okay. But before... Why is there still investigation music if... There's like nothing!
Contrary to what your partner thinks, I think the LeBlanc angle has wheels. You need to follow it up.
Whatever, fine. Screw it, whatever, we're done. Alright, let's go next door. Who are we talking to now? Come on, come on! So, what is it? Interview 1? This guy? Interview 2? What up?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is Detective Earl. Thanks for coming in. Call me Henry. It's the least I could do.
You killed it, didn't you? No. Case closed, Roy. Book him. Alright, so what's your relationship with the victim?
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely.
Uh-huh. Not after all the stuff you gave her. Bullshit. I'm gonna doubt you.
He's asking whether you banged her in a chuck on the shoulder fraternity kind of way.
Oh, Roy.
I'm engaged to be married. It wouldn't be polite.
Bullshit.
Answer the question.
Polite.
This will remain private.
Heather, yeah, you her. Fucked her. Look at that.
Yes. We had relations.
A man with you in business, you can't keep your dick straight, huh? Yeah, went right in, went straight into some other girl, huh?
He said she was seeing an older man. Could have been. I wasn't privy to all the details of Julia's private life.
Well, let's see. Well, what do I got? Let's see. We got no, that's not gonna work. Let's see. Well, what did the housekeeper statement say? Mr. Henderson. Gonna call a lie on that.
Henry, I don't like when people lie to me. She was seeing a man named Henderson. You know who I'm talking about.
Easy
on, detective. I may have heard of Henderson, but I don't know his full name.
Bullshit.
I think he's from New York or someplace back east.
Uh-huh. You probably should have tried the West Coast, because the housekeeper says he works in San Francisco. I was gonna do some slick thing after what I said and just press enter, and I'm like, oh crap, it's the mouse.
That's funny. Julia told her cleaning lady that he lived in San Francisco. Okay,
ooh.
I don't know where he's from. Julia wanted money. She always wanted money.
Yep.
She thought she could get something from this guy. She was wearing a distinctive engagement ring. You think she might have convinced him to buy it for her? Maybe he did, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe he and Julia were getting serious.
So what's up with the burglary suspect?
Ever heard of a Jimmy LeBlanc? No. Should I have? Is he an entertainer or something?
Oh, God, you're so horrible. We gotta doubt you, man. Oh, I got nothing. I mean, I got no. Do I have anything? Nope. Just gonna doubt you.
So you wouldn't have any reason to believe that LeBlanc would be involved in Julie Randall's murder? If this guy is a criminal, he might have been involved. But like I said, I've never heard of this LeBlanc character.
You're full of shit.
Heather told us that you were in fashion.
Well, you're very well dressed.
That's right. Need a drink.
What's this? Henry Arnett, director. The clothing emporium.
Some kind of traveling salesman? Once I got out of the Corps, I used my... You were in the Marines? Sure. I'm proud of it. Fighting 6th. You were in the 6th Marines? Yes. I was a captain. Which company? Various companies. We had a lot of casualties.
Which engagements?
Okinawa. A couple of other places. That would be all for
me. He was like, man, you're full of shit. You're looking at a real Marine.
That son of a bitch was never in the Marines. Why'd you let him off the hook?
That had nothing to do with the case.
Give him a couple of minutes before we start tailing him. Arnett is in.
What the?
We need to find out who killed the
damn, Phelps is so on this case, he'll go right through people.
Have him check the place out and go through his records.
Sure, I'll pass it on.
Thanks. Can you also have R&I run the records on a Jimmy LeBlanc and find out who was his last arresting officer? Have him get in touch via KGPL when they have some information.
God damn, Phelps taking charge! Roy's like, I'm liking you, Phelps.
He's in that car at the lights.
Alright, oh god, another one of these. Alright, I'm gonna save you guys the whole horrendous trouble of all this, and I'll cut right to it. See you guys there. Ooh. Hey, why did I say that? We're here. Wherever this here is. Bought and sold secondhand goods. Looks like his luck was about to run out in a bullet to the face. What the?
Needs money and fast.
Damn, that was fast!
Get in there and find out what he pawned. I'll stick with him. See how he intends to spend the money. Too much slack. Gotta get closer.
Hoof it, Phelps. I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
Alright, so another tailing mission. God damn it! What's up with Vice and just this? Alright, well. Fuck it, let's just keep going. Dun dun
dun dun dun. At risk losing the trail.
Haha! Didn't see that coming, did ya? Don't mind me doing police work. Look at that, sly as a fox. All right, Henry. What else you going? How you gonna cross the street? That's right.
Slack. Gotta get closer.
Oh, relax. What the?
Move in. At risk losing the trail.
Ooh. This is a busy street, okay? What are you doing?
Damn it! This guy, fuck! You win this time, Henry.
Gotta get closer.
All right, we're doing at it again.
I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
What the? No! What the? Oh my god! What? That's bullshit. Alright, let's do this again. Alright, third time's a charm. Let's do it.
Puff it, Phelps. I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
Well, I mean, as long as we're this distance, I guess you can't see me. Woo! Alright, I think this is good enough. I know he's gonna make a quick turn. Is he crossing the street already? Yep, he is. Come on, move! Okay. I know he's gonna cross the street to the right. Come on. Look at that. Good Samaritan waiting across the street. Okay, he's crossing the street. If I could stop getting stuck in this. There it is. Ooh. Can't see me across the street, can you? Oh, shit. Alright, across the street. Alrighty, where is he? There he is. Okay. I'll just follow him on this side of the street. Is he gonna go into the alley? Nope. Alright, keep it real, keeping it real. That's right, I see you. Alright. Tobacconist. Excuse me, sir. Alright, he went over there. Can't lose him. Yeah, relax. Okay. There he is. He's gonna make a left, I think. Yep, obvious. Okay. Well, smart guy. Okay, I'm gonna come over here. Ooh! Okay, there we go. Our Coel? Traveling, huh? Aw, look at that, a happy couple. What up?
That's right, Mexico City. One-way ticket, please. Next available seat.
That would be one day from now. Is that okay?
It's going to have to be.
Damn! Looks like Mexico City.
LAPD, the man who just came in here, he bought a ticket?
Yes, sir. To Mexico City, tomorrow night.
If you hear from him again, don't mention this conversation.
You say anything, I'm gonna come back your ass and beat your ass.
What have you got? He bought a ticket from Mexico City. Tomorrow night.
That's good. But this is better.
Oh, is this a good competition for you now, Roy? Ooh.
Oh my god. It's Fabergé.
Should have seen the look on the pawnbroker's face when I told him to hand it over.
Well, you took all the money.
The joint thought it was worth at least 10 large.
God damn!
A cigarette case. Our net only got 600 clams.
What a loser. Ooh. What is that? Dearest Beverly, with love and affection. I can't read the rest. He's like, I'll take that. Alright, where are we off to now? Well, look at you, park the car with ease, Roy, good on you. I'm gonna go use the phone. What up?
Go ahead, KGPL.
11K, go to Hollywood Station. Homicide detectives Bukowski and Galloway have information relating to the Randall case.
All right.
Roger, KGPL.
All right, let me use the phone real quick.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
All right.
Phelps, badge 1247.
God, I wonder if there's a way to we could skip these things. I mean, I get it, they're, you know, essential to the plot of the whole story, but...
Like, come on.
Okay, yeah, the same thing you just told us. Alright.
Any luck with the arrest record check on Jimmy LeBlanc?
Yes, Detective. Jimmy LeBlanc's last arresting officer was Patrolman Fred Wallace. He
He's posted the Hollywood 9th Beat Sunset Boulevard between Gordon and Wilcox.
Thanks.
All right, we can go meet with the patrolman, or we can go talk to good old buddies. You know, let's go talk to our buddies real quick. Roy, drive us there. I don't want
to
walk.
Drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Fine. Where are we headed?
All right, we'll see you guys there. All right, we're back to the Hollywood Police Station. 6:22 p.m. All right, Bukowski, what do you got?
The contraband list. Items stolen over the last year.
Hang on, I'll dig out a copy for you.
Well, I type it up.
Here you go.
Thanks.
All right, what are we looking for?
Is the cigarette case on there?
Right. There it is for Berge.
It's here. Arnett must be out of his mind trying to move this while under a murder cloud. Julia Randall's ring. It's here.
Yep. All right, what do we got? We got more Miss Beverly. No more Miss Beverly? That's it? Really? Nah, it's gotta be something more.
Get to it, Phelps. Run your own errand.
I'm busy. Yeah. Anything else? Really? Unless we got the same guy, how about Arnett? Oh, that's right, you're right. Should be everything. Diamond brooch, earrings, we got the silver pillbox, Mont Blanc, fountain pen, gold campanella. Yeah, nothing. I guess that's it. Alright. Wait. No, we still got something missing. Alright, what am I looking at? Wireless car radio? No. Okay, we already got the Freiburg cigarette case, we already got the Black Sapphire ring. You know what? I'm just gonna tap everything.
Seems Julia wasn't the first bored society girl to hide her bennies in that pillbox.
Oh, there we go! Okay, I think that's everything. Unless there's something else. Damn, a Bible? $250?
The engagement ring was purloined. Arnett is a cad.
Look at that. What an asshole. Alright, where are the, where are the detectives at?
Are they over here? Oh, where are they at, man? Come on. Julia Randall's got it. Sorry! Alright, let's see. Where are they? Interview room 2? Interview room 1? Where are they? Oh, let's go upstairs. Alright, let's check that out. Where are they? Jesus, come on. Phelps, you're making this ring look bad. No, let's see outside. Wait, it's the stairs. There they are, okay. Has to be one of these rooms. Yes, it's this one. No, it's the tenant's room. Oh, God, I should have paid attention to the layout of this place. Anybody here?
No.
Here. Nope. Roy, you might help me out. Where the hell these guys are? Auto theft. No. No, let's just... Okay, I'll go to the find. What are you doing? Wait, what the fuck? Again, they might be dirty on the case. We got time for this. Oh my god. Roy's like, oh my god, I'm so sick of this. Okay, where are they?
Alright, this time we get to the beat.
Come on, let's give him a hand.
Oh
right
god.
You, Wallace, Detective Phelps.
Just bust their ass.
Wallace, go left. I'm going right after this little prick in the alley.
Go on, come on. Damn, I was like, you know what, fuck it. I couldn't find them in the... Because he said they were at the police station. Come on, man, you can run faster than that. Come on, Phelps. Oh, is it a shootout now? He's dead. He's dead. Look, man, I got time for this. A dead woman's found on Vice. I ain't got time for this, man. I ain't got time for this. Come on.
Guy open here.
$12 hat.
There, done. Now tell us what we want to know. Well, that's it for that.
Thanks. Outstanding warrant, armed robbery. Knocked over a drugstore back there, and it looks like he brought his whole posse with him. Bad luck for them.
They're all yours now. We need some information. Ever heard of a burglar goes by the name of Jimmy LeBlanc?
Sure.
Yeah, busted his ass.
Jimmy on a burglary beef a couple of years back. They cut through a music shop and into a jewelry store.
Pretty smart detective.
Years. I miss his partner, though.
His partner?
Big guy. I had him cornered, and he picked up this huge display case and threw it out a plate glass window.
I mean, it was huge.
He bolted out of there like something out of Barnum and Bailey. The other way.
I would have had him, except for LeBlanc yelling, run for it, Willie.
And you think he was an acrobat of some sort?
More like a strong man. You know. A wrestler, or a boxer, that kind
of thing. You know, a man strong enough to choke a woman in a bathroom. What? What?
You haven't done too badly yourself.
I mean, look at this, all dead bodies. Alright.
Can you drive to this one?
Alright,
where to?
I guess we're going to this ever since. God damn it. Was I supposed to go to this one first? And then go to the other
one?
Because remember,
way.
They said that, Galloway and Rakowski were back home. Back home, back in the station. Willie? Damn it.
A strong man held down Randall while someone administered the morphine. Someone with muscle opened up the long skull. Could be.
Oof. Looks like we got our duo right here. One guy's dead and, well, the other guy's about to be busted their ass. What am I saying? Everstone Residence!
Nice house.
Busted! Bah! Well, oh, come on, man. You should just bust it in like LAPD Vice. Ooh, she got a maid?
LAPD, ma'am. Is Mrs. Evestrom in?
She is. Would you follow me, sir?
Will do. How kind of you. See, you don't need to be a dick this time, Roy.
I am Mrs. Evestrom. How may I help you?
Madam, ooh, that's some nice gloves.
Some stolen goods that belong to you, ma'am.
Yes, of course. That terrible burglary. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you, ma'am.
Roy's like,
why would I mind, young man, if you are returning 43 pieces of my property?
Okay, holy before shit. We get down to that, I'll have a scotch. Thanks, straight up.
Maria, can you get the detective a drink, please?
He seems to be the kind of man who's drunk at 6 o'clock in the afternoon. This Phelps is like, I'm not having any of this. List of stolen items.
Can you describe to us what was stolen?
It would be easier to describe what wasn't stolen, detective.
You think I'm...
A priceless tiara that has been in the family for 50 years. A Fabergé cigarette case that was worth $25,000.
Really? Alright, so what do I got? Got the morphine. Let me just look, cause she looked pretty weird when she said that. Alright. Well. Buddy of mine told me it wasn't worth $25,000. I think you're trying to stick us with something.
Why are you lying about the value of your jewelry, Mrs. Evestrom?
Who do you think you are? Making heinous accusations in my own home.
Oh, they tell like it is, lady, because, you know, the Fabergé cigarette case was only worth $10,000. Well, that's right.
We recovered the cigarette case from a pawnbroker. No one knows the real value of an item better than those guys.
I inflated its value for the insurance claim. There. Are you satisfied?
No.
My daughter's boyfriend was quite taken with the case.
Your daughter's boyfriend?
I think he was even more disappointed than I was when it was stolen.
Ooh. Who's his boyfriend?
What can you tell us about the burglary?
That terrible night. At least a year ago. But let's not go into that. Let's talk about what you've recovered.
Nope. Forgot to turn that off. Let's tell the truth.
Are you in the house when the burglary took place?
Good heavens, no.
I mean, look at me. I would have busted their asses.
Held by a Dr. Harold Stoneman and his lovely wife.
Oh, Stoneman's in on this now.
I returned home and all of my things were missing.
That's about it for now, Mrs. Evestrom. The department will get in touch and let you know how you can recover your valuables.
You have only mentioned a few of the items that have been stolen, Detective. What else has been recovered?
You see, Phelps? That's why you get the drinks in early.
Hello, Mother!
Oh, snap!
Hello, detectives. What is going on?
We'd like to ask exactly the same question.
You have met my daughter?
This morning at work. Oh, mother and father divorced. I took my father's name.
The detectives recovered some of the things that were stolen, darling.
That's what did you find?
A sapphire ring. On the corpse of Julia Randall.
What are you talking about?
You're busted.
Your engagement ring, Miss Swanson. Would you be surprised to know that it was part of the proceeds of a burglary?
That's an outrageous allegation.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
I
and
suggest
we
go straight to Henry Arnett's place and sort this mess out.
Oh, snap. Oh, we're driving her now? Oh, damn it.
This is
all right, fine.
TV, American Century Broadcasting.
Let's go to Arnett's place. There it is.
We go to Washington now. We're
Registered address for Arnett. Alright, I guess we're driving all the way over there. Now I gotta take care of this girl. Nah, I'm just gonna get to it. See you guys there. Oh, finally! Arnett's apartment, 6:58 p.m. This is why I don't drive anymore. It takes forever. Alright, Toots. You're gonna be heading in there first, in case he's got a gun.
Come on, sister. Let's find out who your fiancé really is.
Come on, Phelps, can't you do like a sick ass...
Welcome, sir. I'm sorry, are you arrested?
We're the police. We ain't got time for your bullshit. I wonder if, you know, if the ring was stolen.
Isn't this just nice and awkward?
Way to call it like it is, Roy. Where? Why did they take the mother, you know? She was the one who had her shit stolen. LAPD, sons of bitches. Oh, he's dead.
Stop! LAPD!
Okay, Cole, this guy's our case.
Go on, get
out. Oh, of course. Wait, we're going down, actually. Why am I pressing up? Look, Henry. You're already done for. Just give it up, man. I have the higher ground. We all know how it ended with Anakin Skywalker. He's dead.
Don't make me chase you.
Oh my god, we're doing this. Ooh, no! My hat! You son of a bitch! Alright, come on. Easy now, easy, easy now. It's a little too high, a little too high. Ah! Ah! What? Oh, come on!
Looks like he got you good, Phelps.
Yeah, he really packs a wallop.
You look kind of skinny.
Under your own steam, miraculously. You came in through the window, said hello, and then keeled over.
I mean, it was hilarious.
How was Arnett?
He's coming around, too. He's all hopped up. Good time to get some answers.
All right.
Did you see something, Henry?
Hmm? A suitcase? You son of a bitch. What's this, huh? A one-way ticket to Mexico. Look at that.
You told Heather you're honeymooning without her?
Ooh. No, she's not gonna like that. We got a... What is this? A knife? Wait. A watch.
Asheron Constantine. That's an extremely expensive watch, Henry.
You know damn well you can't afford this shit.
A graduation present from my parents.
Bullshit. Okay, I guess, you know, he's all about neatness. Let's look around. You got nothing on your, Oh, a fan, huh? Looks like a man who likes to keep himself cool. What else? What else? What else we got? We got nothing. We got a dartboard. Let's go look over in the light. So I can hear. Oh, no, that's the outside. let's see. You got, what is that? A cigarette? Garbage. Let's see. Oh, damn, I look great. And I lost my hat. What is that? Matchbook?
Well,
alright, let's put that down. Let's look around. Is that everything? Nah, that can't be everything. I don't know what that is, but that looks unnecessary. Let's look over here. What do we have? Nope, nothing. What's what? Outside. Fresh air. Nope. Alright. You're not gonna talk.
We know all about the jewelry ring. You and Randall and LeBlanc and Willie doing the legwork. I'm in the fashion business.
Bullshit.
You're lying, Henry. How can you prove that I'm involved, detective?
Well, let's look at the case. I mean, besides just that fucked up face. Alright, so we can't really use the ticket, because obviously... Where's... Oh! The cigarette case, because that's what you pawned off.
Because you pawned a Fabergé cigarette case today for $600. A case that is on a list of stolen items.
Ooh.
It was Julia's idea. Get a list of society parties, and find out where and when, and then have the guest burglar.
Julia was desperate for money. No matter how much we made, she always wanted more.
So you filled up her bottle, didn't you? Her face was like, oh! Alright, so why did you murder?
LeBlanc killed Julia Randall. I wanted to stop. To get out of that life. She could marry Heather if she'd have
it. Well, she ain't gonna have your ass now.
Julia told the others that they were out. That she was gonna create a new gang.
Look at her face like, oh my god.
And that's why you did it, huh?
So then why were you trying to...
I think you ordered them to kill her. It was made to look like suicide, and when the coroner saw through that, you knew it was time to run. I told you I was involved in the burglaries.
Really?
I had nothing to do with Julia's
So then
death.
Why were you getting the hell out of here?
I need to run.
Well... And she was like, uh-huh. Well, what's up with this Mexican ticket, huh?
Have you told Miss Swanson that you're leaving for Mexico City tomorrow night?
Ooh!
Tell me it isn't true.
It is. He's just like,
I had no choice. I wanted to marry Heather.
What, in Mexico?
I told Julia I wanted out, and she laughed in my face. To pay Willie and Jimmy a fortune to do her, and now I'm completely broke.
What you are, Buster, is under arrest.
Oh, snap, Roy. Thanks for the help.
Who is Henderson, and what is his involvement?
Tell them what you know, Henry. I'll stand by you if you'll only tell the truth.
There is no Henderson.
You're full of shit. Because we saw that name like how many times?
First burglary, and don't lie. I can't remember. I don't keep a list of these things.
Well, I sure did, and that's a whole hell of a contraband list we got down here.
Your first burglary was a Dr. Harold Stoneman. You want to explain how he is involved, or shall I? Henderson is Stoneman. He was crazy about
you. Ah, so it was the doc fucking the patient.
Whatever she wished. He threw the parties, and we arranged the burglaries. Julia never let him touch her. She just kept him hanging on the promise.
Women, they do that.
Henry Arnett, you are under arrest for burglary. And for the murder of Julia Randall. Henderson is Stoneman, all right? I'm not the guy you want. Go talk to the good doctor.
Oh, we'll bust his ass too.
Knucklehead. Meanwhile, we're fitting you for convict stripes.
Roy's like, yeah, I participated. Justice is served. Man, but I wanted to go meet up with my good buddies. Oh, maybe I still can. Oh, no, I can't. I want to go talk to my old pals. God damn it.
You're behind the wheel.
That's stupid. Why would they have tell me to go visit the Hollywood station and then the... Oh, God, fuck it, whatever. I'm sorry, guys. I wanted to you guys to see everything.
Isn't that the cop who solved the big case and got promoted?
Okay, anyways, we'll see you guys there. All right, guess we're here. Dr. Stoneman. You're done. Come on, let's take the elevator ride one more time. Guys, a lot of waiting in the vice cases. Jesus.
Time for the doctor to give us something to make this all better.
His life. Get your guns ready. I don't think I've seen the last of the guy who just beat my ass.
Hang on a moment, sister. Tell him it's Henry Arnett. And tell him it's urgent.
I can't do that.
Do it.
Tell him, or I'll charge you with obstruction of justice.
And you know what's happened to pretty girls like you.
Doctor, I'm afraid Mr. Arnett is here to see you, and he says it's urgent.
Send him in.
Pull out your gat. It's about to go down.
I told you never to come.
Tell us the truth, Doctor.
Huh? Wham! Just give him a good smack.
So glad you came. Prison will be better than insanity, and I'm already half insane with grief.
You killed her.
I loved her.
Yep.
I ruined my life for her, and yet I still love her.
Then she's dead.
Will you testify in court that Arnett and Randall did these robberies?
They organized the robberies. Julie would get the names of the guests attending my wife's parties.
You have a wife?
Didn't matter how much money I showered upon her, it was never enough.
Oh yeah, she's a whore.
She never really cared for me.
She played you like a fiddle, man.
You're under arrest.
It's just like, just gonna have to be sister and you're getting charged with obstruction of justice. Why? Because I don't like you.
The practice. You'll call Dr. Gerard. No.
Don't cry. She's like, I wanted you.
To see no one. Not my wife, or my children, nor my friends. And I don't want a lawyer. Just lock me up and throw away the key.
Oh, damn. Hey, look at that. He already got in the position. All right.
What have I done?
Oh, son of a bitch.
Didn't see that coming.
Fucking Roy. But the zinger in the end. Yeah, you can cry all you want, sister. He's dead. Well, I guess I'll use his telephone.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
I need an ambulance and the coroner immediately to the offices of Dr. Harold Stoneman, 1646 Ivor Street, Hollywood.
En route, detective. You have a message. Detective Bukowski says the suspect is named Wilson Willie the Wolf Reed, former wrestler.
Ooh.
Last known address is an apartment building at the corner of Hollywood and Vine. Detective Bukowski says to meet them there.
All right. I guess we are meeting our good buddies there. Man, it's a long case. All right, let's head over there, Roy.
We have an address for the runner.
You know, I'm going to save you guys the trouble of the drive and everything, and I'm going to see you guys right over there. Damn, we're already there. Holy shit, that was fast. Broadheywood at Willie's apartment, 1 a.m. Oh, it's what we see on the, loading screen. Yeah. Things are about to get interesting here in LA Noir.
He's around here somewhere. A big guy. Neighbors say he always wears basketball shoes and a cream
dress. Hey, Rusty.
Get this. The kids around here say he plays the harmonica.
Find the game well and have the commander set up a dragnet. We want the area closed off. We'll take this out of the street.
Yeah, I guess Phelps calling the shots here. All right.
A harmonica playing wrestler. That's a good one. Think he knits as well?
Look at that.
Just keep your eyes open and your mouth shut. I don't want him to pull across.
Oh, I hear it. You hear it, everybody? What? Ah, there it is. Nope, that's not it. I mean, it's coming through there. Oh, there she is.
Wilson Reed, LAPD, give yourself up.
No, well, there he is. Where is he? What? Damn it, he's getting away! What the hell were you doing, man? Come on! Alright, let's get up there. Come on, hurry, Phelps. It's time to get revenge for him putting him in my place last time. Come on, Reed. You're done, skis. You know one thing I always found amazing about this? The shoes that they're on, like, you know, the shoes that they have, they're so hard to run in. I mean, goddamn. The Texans back then not only looked great, but damn could they run. I mean, look at those shoes. I can never run in that shit. Alright, come on, we're almost there. Okay. The higher he goes, the harder he's gonna fall, and it's gonna be in great. Well, where is he?
Hold it. He's gotta be around here somewhere. No place to go unless he grew wings.
Yep. He's just like, ugh.
Wait, the son of a
bitch. Oh! Look. Hollywood ain't got enough. Can I knock him down? Nope. Oh, I gotta. Oh, okay. Give my regards to Hollywood.
He really picked a spot for it up here, didn't he?
Yep. He's like, over there, boss.
Julia Randall's folks are flying in from New York tomorrow to claim the body. I saw her on the slab. So perfect. Looked like she was made of porcelain.
A little creepy there, boss.
She really made an impression on me.
Leah had that impact on a lot of men.
Christ, it's cold. You guys did good work here today. Roy, I think you should buy your brother officers a drink.
He's like,
do you now? That's very generous of you, Lieutenant.
Roy's getting a little salty. What's this? 8 million stories. Okay. Anyways, there we go. We come to the conclusion of the Naked City case on the Vice City desk. And, BAM! Look at that. Julie Randall lived fast and died young, sending one man to jail and three to the morgue. Well, guys, again, thanks for watching the videos, and let me know if you guys enjoy these kinds of gameplays. If not, you want me to play, you know, scary game, more action games. I mean, right now, I'm just playing anything I really like. I know really soon, Overwatch is going to be dropping by, so I'm going to be doing not gameplays, really, per se, unless I find, like, a good group to play with, you know, that could be funny, both, you know, game-wise, entertaining-wise, but I'm going to be doing, like, streams of those, you know, getting to know the game a little better, and who knows, maybe getting to know you guys a lot more. But, like I always say, you guys, if there's any games you guys would like me to play, or something you guys would like me to check out, or videos you think my type of personality would be good for, you know, let me know. You know, in the comments below, or send me a message, or anything. But if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like. If you really enjoy what I do, and the way I do it, which will probably do a lot better, coming around, then hit that subscribe button. But as always, have yourselves a wonderful morning, afternoon, breakfast, dinner, lunch, evening, tea time, second tea time. If you're watching this in Christmas, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy Kwanzaa. If you're watching this in Easter or Passover, happy those. Happy Thanksgiving. And happy days and nights. Yes. Well, anyways, guys, I'll see you guys in the next video, in the next case of the Vice City Desk here in LA Noir. Bye-bye.